So far of this TROY-BILT saw, an 18-inch chain that's on it, it's a 62DL38. This chain works great. This chainsaw works great compared to the Ryobi that I did in an earlier review. They're both out of the box. First time using. I own two Ryobis, same problem. Sputters, blah, blah, blah. Piece of garbage. This thing, so far, works the way it should. And if I have a chance to buy another saw like this, I'm going to buy it. I'll show you the Ryobi, which is a just awful, awful saw. RY37 16 inch, and no, I wasn't trying to cut stumps with this. I was actually cutting up a fallen tree, and this thing would sputter and the chain grate would come on intermittently. This chainsaw do not buy at all. I might even do a comparison of these two in another video, but things are going so well and I need to get things done today. I don't know, we'll see. This is a very frustrating saw, and we'll go back to the store. This Ryobi is a 38cc. That one is a 42. And it has nothing to do with the size engine, because it's a carburetor issue with the Ryobi. I can tell you this saw is not as easy on gas as the Ryobi, but who cares about that when you're constantly trying to start it and it stalls, right? Start a project, you want to finish it. guys, the chain, a little loose, which is normal. This will not slack. I don't need the chain to come off and ruin my day. Okay, so my fish is soft. Our fish trunk up. The only time it did stall on me when I was using it just now, because I accidentally hit the on-off button. Once I put the on-off button, if you're right-handed, you put it right there. So when you reach around, your thumb can accidentally hit. Your thumb can accidentally hit this when you're cutting. Oh well, it's only minor. So far, I really love this saw.